Nice job, guys. Dissolve there while I'm scratching my nose. Hi, welcome to Up Your Alley, the number one bowling show this side of the equator. And the only bowling show in the world to offer a trip to Toronto. See, we're the only ones in the world because it's our rules. So no one else can do this. But the only one to offer a trip to Toronto to the winner of the Up Your Alley Tournament of Champions. Now, I am Kevin Kramus. I am the cable dude. Oh, no, it's the cable guy. That's what they're telling me. I am the cable guy. And this show is being brought to you through a grant from the Garden City Cable Commission. If you, too, would like to put a show together of your own, just contact the Cable Commission through Garden City City Hall, and they'd be more than happy to help you put a show together of your own. Now, the way you qualify for the Tournament of Champions is bowl a high game. Now, the top five high games so far in Up Your Alley are right here on the mat. Ron Pummel, our number one seed, he bowled a 231. Now, he can better that because he's bowling today. John Lemanic, he bowled a 202. He's our second seed. He was beat out last week by Ron Pummel. Tom Tansky, who used to be our first seed, is now our third seed. He bowled a 183 game. Ed Kane and Hank Larson are tied down there in the fourth spot with a 181 tie. Now, the beginning of the Up Your Alley Tournament of Champions, on the first show, Hank Larson and Ed Kane Sr. will bowl off their 10th frame for positioning, and then we'll start the tournament. Now, the tournament is the fifth seed bowls the fourth seed, the winner bowls three, the winner bowls two, and then the winner goes on to bowl number one, and the winner of that will go on to Toronto. That's a trip of two, 3 days and two nights in Toronto, courtesy of your travel planner. And that's conveniently located in the Sheridan Square on Ford Road. Now, something in there probably didn't make sense that I was talking about because people seem to be laughing here, but that's okay. This is Saturday morning, and I should be watching Smurfs. So it's excusable. Now, the tournament will be taped on December 3rd. All four shows will be December 3rd. I am not Larry. Larry is the guy that works at the balloon ride down on Ford Road, and he's also the guy that sells M&M's here in Up Your Alley. And if we had a time-based corrector, we might be able to go to a shot of Larry selling me M&M's, but we just can't do that. And now every bowler on today's show will get a complimentary box of M&M's from Larry. The tournament will be taped on December 3rd right here at Garden Lanes. 10 o'clock in the morning is the first show. That's what time the show will be taped. And this, everybody come on down here to the Garden Lanes and be on the show, and it'll just be a fun time for all. Those will also be the Christmas shows, and Santa may arrive. Right now we'd like to bring up Justine Pummel. She's bowling against her husband Ron, and Ron is giving her 55 pins. How you doing today?
Fine. Really good.
Do you think you have a real good chance today of beating him?
Well, of course. I wouldn't be here. I come to win.
How many years have you been bowling?
Oh, about 4 years on league, you know, yeah.
You know, like, yeah, on a league.
Well, I never bowled on a league till 4 years ago.
You're not an articulation teacher, are you?
I am a sixth grade teacher at Lathers Elementary School.
So this is not Justine Pummel, this is Mrs. Pummel.
Right. Right.
Is there any, like, students out there you'd like to say hello to?
Oh, my whole class. Hello.
Do you, like, favor any kids because they're smarter and some kids
no.
that...
Oh, no, they're all great. All great.
You're sure?
Positive. They have me for a teacher.
So the class doesn't go real well, but everybody likes you.
Everyone likes me. The class goes great.
How do you feel being a teacher when most of the kids are taller than you?
A lot of them are taller than me. I just wear
That's
heels.
What I said.
Every so often I wear heels.
Oh. Can I come to your class?
Sure. Gotta go to the office first.
There you see a shot of her husband laughing. He's the laughing guy. Oh, that's kind of neat. Whoa. Can you turn me into Ron Pummel again? Wait a minute. One, two, three. Oh, look at that. Oh, my gosh. The wonders of television.
That's right.
For a minute there, you thought I was Ron.
Never.
Okay, wait a minute. Who's this? Send this girl down here because I got to pay her for the food. Send her down here. We can't get the girl down here. We're going to get the fries down. $2.35 for the fries. So you're going to wish him good luck?
Definitely.
You're going to win.
Thank you.
Justine Pummel, ladies and gentlemen. Sixth grade teacher at Lathers Elementary School. And right now, what's going on here? Oh, she won't come on. Let's bring up Ron Pummel. He's our one-week champion. He beat John Lemanic last week, and he qualified number one seed. How you doing today, Ron?
Great. How's it going?
All right. Can you do that? Can you turn me into Justine now? So you're ready to beat your wife?
I'm ready to bowl my wife. We're gonna have to. I'll know more in 10 frames whether what happens there.
Now, who wears the pants in the family?
We both do. You'll notice she'll have jeans, I have jeans. We both wear them there, so it goes good. Great marriage.
How long have you been married?
4.5 years, just over 4.5.
That long?
That long.
And
still newlyweds, though, of course.
Of course.
Of course.
Were you ever on the newlywed game or anything?
Never. Should have been, but they didn't call us, so you're our first show. You're our debut show.
I could have her come down here, and then we could ask you some questions about Whoopi.
I think we better bowl instead. I appreciate the offer, but let's bowl.
That's good.
That's good.
Well, is there anybody out there you'd like to say hi to?
Yeah, my mom, and then my in-laws are back for this week's show to see her daughter and stuff, and
our daughter. So there's the three of you.
Their daughter and then my wife. It works that way, kind of. And so I'd like to say my mom, who's probably glued to the television right now. So hi, Mom, Bill, Wes, Beth, and the gang there.
Oh, terrific. God. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
Ron Pummel, he's our number one seed in that tournament. Well, we'll be back with more Up Your Alley right after this.
From the Garden Lanes in Garden City, this is Omni Edition's Up Your Alley. Brought to you by Geppetto's, located in the Garden Plaza on Ford Road. By King Cone, on Ford Road just east of Merriman. By J&D Silk Screening and More on Middle Belt Road, across from Garden City High School. By the Garden Lanes on Warren Road, just east of Middle Belt. By Tales and Tapes Bookstore, located in the Sheridan Square. And by Your Travel Planner, also in the Sheridan Square and all in Garden City. Here now, your host, Kevin Kramus.
Hi, welcome back here to Up Your Alley. Right now, we're going to have Justine Pummel bowl, and she's going to step right up to the line and bowl. That was the longest open in history. Oh, and a strike there for Justine Pummel. Nice job. Good ball. That'll bring up her husband. I would like to congratulate George Bush on winning the presidency. I received 12 votes. Electoral votes. And a spare there for Ron. What I wanted to do is I wanted to turn the White House into a 400-lane bowling alley. And I wanted bowling on Air Force One. And there's Ron's shot. Oh! And a strike there for Ron Pummel. Now what happened is the pin came off the board. Now a bowling pin needs to be knocked 9 degrees off his axis to fall down. It was like 8.5 there. And because the building was designed by a man who can't get floors straight, the pin fell. We of Harold Larson keeping score today. I'd like to thank Harold for keeping score. Katie Rowe in here. She's watching Justine Bull. And there's Teen Shot. And she'll finish with a 7 count there in that frame. That'll put her here in her third frame. So she's throwing at a sleeper combination here on the left-hand side of the lane. Knocked down 8 on her first ball. A good shot at it. She only picked up 1. Nice try. So who runs the finances in the household?
We both do.
Now, if you happen to win...
We spend more, though. No, we spend together.
So this is just all the togetherness, a 50-50
right.
Thing.
Until you 100. That's right.
Until you, like, leave the bowling alley. And then you just wrap him back around your finger, don't you? So, Harold, how are the scores going as of now?
Same as usual.
Right now, Justine with an 88 in the third frame. Ronnie with a strike in the second. He has 40 in the second frame. Justine has that 55-pin handicap that was added in the first frame. And he knocked down 7 there. So how long have you worked here at the bowling alley? And what's your name?
Jenny.
Jenny. Phillips. Jenny Phillips, ladies and gentlemen. She is the girl at the snack bar. The lady of my fries. So Ronnie picks up the spare there. Nice ball. And we're bringing the Duff's smorgasbord into the picture. The hills are alive with the sound of cholesterol. Strike there. Nice ball. Need some salt. I'll go get some salt.
Okay.
Got to go talk to Jenny Phillips again. She's the salt monger here at the bowling alley. I'm going to borrow your salt if you don't mind. And just off to the left. A nice ball there. She's throwing at the 2 pins right now. Big spare would help her. There it is. I think she's got a shot at it. She picks up the spare. Nice job.
What a pressure on the feet. What a
pressure. A good shot of Ronnie wiping his ball off. Lanes are a little oily. And a strike there. He's starting out early like he did in the last game. And not enough break on that ball.
Is that a
So what's the score, Harold?
Right now, through the fourth, it's 108 for Justine, 77 for Ron, and they both mark.
Now, that doesn't qualify for a split because you have to knock down the head pin.
I was just checking.
And that doesn't qualify as a spare because you have to knock down all of them on the second ball.
I thought about that.
What do you think about my jacket, Harold?
It's really nice. Well, I was just going to ask you after the show where you got it so I could get one.
At the, at PA's, I think that's, or PH's, PH's. That's an acronym, PH.
I'm not good at that. I've never been in Ohio that far.
Ball right on target. And only one. So the score through six frames, 133 to 105. Ron is losing. A smooth approach. And the five pin will stay.
I would have brought my crayons. If I would have known I was writing on this, I would have brought my crayons.
Crayons?
Yeah. Yes. So you can see better with bright, you know, big wide numbers.
Open your eyes, Harold. Oh, and just to the left. She knew it when she threw it. So we can tell she's a sixth grade teacher. She's making rhymes as we go along. She knew it as she threw it. And a strike there for Ron. Good ball. So what kind of stuff do you learn in the sixth grade now?
Everything. We do math a lot. We're working on our math, going to learn fractions and social studies. You learn countries of the world, about different countries of the world.
Is Mr. Furnimo still at Lathers?
No, he's, I don't know where he's at, but he's not at Lathers.
He was my sixth grade teacher at Memorial. Do you give kids wax? He used to give kids wax.
No, I don't give kids wax.
Do you play paddleball with them and stuff?
No, we don't get to play paddleball either.
You are no fun. Do you play football with the kids?
No, but I have been known to play dodgeball and softball with them.
Do you ever get detention walking through the junior high? Because you don't look any older than me.
No, I don't, but sometimes I do get mistaken as not being a teacher.
Have you ever, like, walk down the halls at Lathers and get yelled at by the principal because she thinks you should be in your class? So Justine with that 55-pin handicap, she's charging ahead. She has a 142 in the seventh frame, Ron with a 125 in the seventh frame. She actually hasn't even broken 100. Good ball. Oh, she picks up two. She picked up the hard ones. This show, just not the excitement of last week's.
No, that's true. I agree with you.
But we're still having a good time.
Oh, yeah. Anytime we're here, we're having a good time.
Anytime. And off to the left one more time. She knocked down five. What was that?
That's the bucket with a man in motion. That's a bowling term.
That's a bowling term?
Oh, I know that.
A man in motion?
Well, yeah, you got... Never mind.
Nice ball. I think she has a shot at it. She picks it up. Let's give her a hand. Nice job. Here in the ninth frame for Justine. She has 160 with that spare. So she's so far she's bowled a 105.
And yeah, for her that's good. What's her average?
Strike there for Ron. Nice strike. When he finds his groove, it's all over. Ron here in the 10th frame, a strike in the 9th. Last week he had threw two in the 10th. And today he got a little lucky, but not on that ball. He threw and knocked down 9. 164 so far for Ron. He needs to pick this up and mark to put some pressure on Justine. He picked up that one. He'll get one more ball here in the 10th frame. Possible 185. So Ronnie finishes with a 181. That'll bring up Justine. She has a spare in the 9th. She has a possible 190 game. With 3 in a row here in the 10th. She knocked down 4 there. So she needs a mark here. A mark and 7.
No, 8.
Mark and 7 to tie, mark and 8 to win. And I think she has a shot at this.
Right.
She picks that up. 7 to tie, 8 to win. Right down, we have a photo finish. She could get it. And she's our new champion. We'll be back with more Up Your Alley right after this. Hi, welcome back. This is the end of the show. Right now, I'd like to bring up Ron Pummel. Ron lost by 2 pins. He lost to his wife, Justine. But Ron is our number one qualifier in the Up Your Alley. Where is he? Tournament of Champions. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
We'll see you in the tournament.
I hope to. Yeah, I'll be here, the 3rd of
December 3rd.
I'll be here.
What seemed to happen today?
My wife beat me. That's I bowled, she bowled better.
It was a good game.
It was a great one, yeah.
It was a real good match.
Yeah, it was close all the way. But hey, in America, you can bowl competitively with your wife and be as happy about losing as you can with it. So, hey, she's gonna beat the next guy.
Oh, well said. Well said.
I didn't even read that. That was my own. I just made that up. So,
that's good.
Thank you. That's why I'm a teacher. So.
Well, we're gonna get a T-shirt out to you. We'll probably have it out for you at the Tournament of Champions, and we'll see you December 3rd.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Ron Pummel, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, I'd like to bring up our new champion. She'll go on to face Chuck Morris next week, the last week that a person can qualify for the tournament. Let's bring her up right now. Justine Pummel, our new champion. Great job.
Thank you.
Well, you turned down the heat there at the end.
I bowled awful. I think it was that big spot they gave me.
It could have been.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, if you wouldn't have had that, I don't think you would have had a chance.
I don't think so either.
But you have a 148 average anyway, so yeah. You had a chance.
Yeah. I just didn't bowl my average, though.
Were you sandbagging it, maybe?
Not at all. I think I was just feeling really uncomfortable.
The lights and...
Yeah, the camera.
Me. Come on, say it. Come on, come on.
No.
I'll, like, write on the blackboard when we leave.
Okay.
All right, well, we'll give you some prizes, and we'll have a T-shirt out for you.
All right.
Gift certificate from King Cone, Geppetto's and Tails and Tapes, and we'll see you next week.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Justine Pummel, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, now we have a special. This is the first part segment. This is the first segment on a 10-part series. And right now we are going, we haven't done this before, but we're taking a walk. Come along with me. We're going to see Jenny down here in the snack bar. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Garden Lane Snack Bar, and it's just a great place to eat. So we're going to come around here. How you doing today, Jenny?
I just broke a nail.
She just broke a nail. So you putting a Band-Aid on?
Yes, it's bleeding.
Did you have customers here?
Yes, she needed ice.
Did you give it to her?
Yes.
Oh, well, nice job. Now, how did you actually break the nail?
I dropped a bag of french fries on it.
Ladies and gentlemen, check this out, the hair. She slept on one side of her face, which was this side, and her hair went up, and... How long does it take to get it like that?
About 10 minutes.
10 minutes. And does it take like 400 gallons of hairspray?
No, just one.
You know, you could be the cause when like the ozone layer goes away.
No, I don't use that kind of hairspray.
What kind of hairspray do you use?
The kind in the pump bottle.
Non-aerosol, the pump bottle. Now, tell us a little bit about what's happening here at they're looking for help. Anybody interested in working at a bowling alley snack bar? Just call 722-7790. That's 722-7790 if you are interested in working here at the snack bar. Now, what kind of things do we have here?
Food and drinks.
Food and drinks.
Uh-huh.
Well, that pretty much puts it in a nutshell, doesn't it?
Yes.
Well, thank you. And your name was?
Jenny.
Jenny Phillips. You told us that at the beginning.
Uh-huh.
Just seeing if you can remember. Thanks a lot, Jenny. Thanks for being on Up Your Alley. Now, if you look out here, it's wonderful outside. There's locks on the door, and it's just a great time for all. And I shall stand right here in front of the glass. And we're gonna see you people next week. Watch Garden City Planning for a Better Tomorrow right after this. So for Oz, the man on camera right here who's making me look taller than ever, I'm Kevin Kramus. Thanks to everybody being on our crew. We'll see you next week.
Noble fights. I once believed in causes to have my voice.